मॉर्निंग पीपल, गुड मॉर्निंग यूट्यूब, डॉक्टर हर्ष हियर, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। टुडे इज सैटरडे, द टाइम इज अराउंड 6:20। आई एम ऑन NH4 पोस्ट नेलमंगला टोल, इट इज पार्लेजी टोल, गोइंग ऑन फॉर ए वेरी शॉर्ट स्पिन, ए ब्रेकफास्ट राइड अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग, या गोइंग टू बेंगलुरु मंगलुरु हाईवे, going for a restaurant by name Swati Delicacy, which is around 70 kilometers from this place. Today I just want to talk about the decision behind why GSXS 750, Suzuki GSXS 750. See, as far as you people know, I have already two bikes in my garage. One is Himalayan Street, which is a year old, which I've done around 13,000 kilometers. The other one is KTM RC 390, which has got a Powertronics ECU and which has got Agrapovic free flow exhaust, and it has done around 37,000 kilometers, which is a 3-year old bike. So basically I had the itch of just upgrading this year, and I was a bit confused whether I have to upgrade my adventure bike or whether I have to upgrade my street bike. Initially I was more inclined towards upgrading to an adventure bike. Then I test rode Africa Twin also, I test rode V-Strom also, but I didn't test ride Triumph 800. I tested only these two vehicles because Triumph 800 was not in my vision when I decided for adventure bike. Africa Twin is a really gem of a bike, built like a tank, a premium built quality, and it's a Honda. Honda is always a Honda, as you people know. Why? Because the service and the maintenance cost is really less, and it ages very gracefully. I liked Honda Africa Twin a lot. I thought it had got optimal power for an adventure bike category. The only point, the points which were not in favor of Africa Twin for me were the price, obviously. The 2018 model was coming up to 16.7 or 8 lakhs on road in Bangalore. And the one more point was its weight. It was around 243 kilos weight, the DCT version, whatever we have in India. And I am a puny guy. I weigh around 58 or 59 kilos. I am around 5'9, 5'10. I know the weight won't be an issue once the bike is on board, but at some point of time weight also matters. So these were the two negative points of Africa Twin which held back my purchase of Africa Twin. And I test rode Suzuki V-Strom. It is also a very nice adventure bike. I liked it. And one more thing, the Honda Africa Twin, I felt it was overpriced for the segment by at least 2 lakhs. Similarly, the V-Strom also, I felt it was overpriced by at least 75 to 80 thousand for its segment. Somehow after riding Africa Twin, I thought the power of V-Strom was not that adequate. If at all I put full luggage on the bike and I take a pillion rider also, I felt I'll overgrow the power of V-Strom very early, and that itch for upgrading again comes back soon. At the same time, the ground clearance, I was not really comfortable with the ground clearance of V-Strom, around 170 mm. After putting complete luggage on the bike and with the pillion rider, it might go down by another 10 or 20 mm. So I was really not comfortable with that ground clearance for an adventure bike category. So at the same time I got the information that KTM 700 Adventure might be launching in the end of the year 2019 or starting of the year 2020. That suits perfectly my build because it's less weight, it's around 206 kilo including all the fluids, and being KTM they'll price very aggressively. Probably it will be in the range of around 12 lakhs, I guess, 12-13 lakhs for a vehicle of that category is quite okayish, I feel. And I know presently there are some legals which are going on in 790 Adventure. KTM is like that only. Usually in the initial year they'll have some amount of niggles. When they leave version 2 or version 3, that is after 2-3 years, almost all the niggles will be ironed out. So that is when we have to purchase a KTM bike. That is what I have come to a conclusion after owning a KTM bike. So I thought I'll wait for 790 Adventure, and if at all I'll purchase in the year 2020. That's why I kept aside the adventure bike category. And I didn't test ride Triumph 800 because it was out of my reach again. It's very costly. The spec what I want in Triumph Tiger will cost around 15-16 lakhs, similar to Honda Africa Twin. I didn't have so much amount of money to shell out, so I didn't go to test ride Triumph Tiger. I test rode Africa Twin in spite of knowing the price, because I am always a fan of Africa Twin. The way it looks, and it's Honda, and everybody was going gaga over Africa Twin build quality, the premium quality and all. So that's why I was more inclined towards Africa Twin than Triumph Tiger. That's why I test rode Africa Twin. Coming to the second category, that is street naked. I was okay with the naked version also, and I was okay with the fade version also. The bikes which I shortlisted were, one is Suzuki GSXR 750, the other one was Z900, the other one is Street Triple, and the other one is Honda CBR 650R. I considered KTM Duke 780 also, which is going to be released probably in the month of April or May. One thing I was pretty sure that it has to be an inline 4, if at all it has to be a street bike or a fade version. No question of parallel twin, either inline 4 or inline 3, no question of parallel twin. That's why I excluded KTM 780 Duke. I feel the engine of KTM 780 Duke is more apt for adventure bike rather than a street bike. That's what I feel. That was my opinion. That is my opinion. And I always wanted a street bike with an horsepower of more than 100. Anything north of 100 is okay with me. Anything less than 100 is not okay with me. And CBR 650R is around 94 HP in the international model. Obviously for India, he'll due tune for the 91 octane petrol what we use. So it'll be around 87 or 88 horsepower, the Indian version. I was not okay with it. That's why I excluded Honda CBR 650R. Even though it looks fantastic, it looks brilliant, it looks beautiful, and even though it's Honda, because I have driven CBR 650F for a quite number of hours. My friends have got CBR 650F. I like the bike, but the acceleration, the power is not that mind-blowing. It's okay-ish. So I was not pretty comfortable with that bike, purchasing Honda CBR 650R. And coming to Street Triple is very costly for me. It was not affordable. I just wanted any bike which will cost less than 10 lakhs, around 10 lakhs or less than 10 lakhs. It will be really convenient for me. And Street Triple or RS is north of 10 lakhs, which are not affordable. That's why I dropped Street Triple also. So coming to the most commonly seen bike in this category, most adored bike in this category, Z900, Kawasaki Z900. The things which I liked about Kawasaki Z900 are, even though it's priced around 10 lakh category, it's a 950cc cylinder, 950cc engine bike, which is almost equivalent to a liter class bike, and the power is really good, 125 horsepower. The torque is really good, around 91 or 92 newton meters of torque. The low end power is good, the middle power is middle rev power is good, the top end is also good. So it's like it's a really a good bike in the performance wise. But the factors which I didn't like However, it's a Kawasaki. Why? Because Kawasaki service is not that great in Bangalore. And being a Kawasaki, procuring the parts is really difficult in Kawasaki. We have to wait for months together, which I have seen in my friend's case. That's why I'm telling you people. And at the same time, I don't like the looks of Z900, the way it has been designed. The front end I don't like, the rear end I don't like, the tank shape I don't like, and presently the colors, whatever they are left for 2019, pop red. I just don't like the colors of that. So these factors were the, and it doesn't have traction control, which I really wanted in a bike of that much amount of power. At least I wanted an ABS and traction control. These are the two requirements which I wanted in the safety department in the bike which I am going to purchase now. Which were the traction control was not there in Z900. I am not interested in the riding modes, cornering ABS. Cornering ABS is really good if at all I have for that price, but it's expecting more for that price. So traction control was a minimum requirement for me in that price category, in that power category, which was not there in Z900. And the points which favored me to go to GSX 750 were, I really like the looks of GSX 750. It looks really mean. It looks really mean. On the pics, it doesn't look that aggressive and that mean. But personally, in flesh, it really looks great, guys. Listen to me. Believe me. I like the way the tank is shaped. I like the way the headlight is shaped. I like the way the tail end is shaped. And it's being a Suzuki. Usually, I have a soft corner for Suzuki because my the first bike which I bought in the initial days of my MBBS in 1995-1996 was Suzuki Shogun. So everyone has got a sweet place for the brand, first brand which they bought when they were in their early 20s. Similarly, I also have a soft corner for Suzuki. And at the same time, the engine, whatever they have used, the inline 4, whatever they use for S750 is a legendary K5 series engine, which was used in GSXR 750 in 2005. It's a legendary engine, and the engine speaks for itself, that inline 4. And it has got traction control, four modes of traction control, including one mode where it can be switched off completely. And it has got an ABS, the recent generation ABS, which is really good. And it's a butter smooth engine, guys. It's really very smooth. And it has got the typical inline 4 character. That is the initial, the lower revs, it doesn't have much torque and power. But as the revs build up, it goes bonkers. It's a maniac. The animal is unleashed. That is a typical inline 4 engine character, which I really like. That was there in Suzuki GSX 750. And the price was okay. It was around 9.5 lakhs on road, and it was ready to bargain. The fellow who was selling that bike to me, Suzuki Ariya, I got a good bargain on this bike. The only negative point about the 750 is the service interval is once in 4000 kilometers. So I have to service thrice in a year, and service costs around 7000 to 8000 per service, including the labor charge and oil change and all. There are no free service for this bike, remember. I got my first service done around 10 days back when I crossed 1000 kilometers. It costed me around 8000 rupees, 8100 rupees, including the oil change and labor charge. The servicing is a bit costlier compared to Honda, but not that costlier as compared to Kawasaki. And the frequency is also more compared to Honda and Kawasaki. But that is for initial 2 years where the warranty period is there. But once the warranty period is over, we can service once in 6 months. That's not a big deal. So that's how I ended up in purchasing Suzuki GSXS 150, guys. And I really like the paint scheme of this bike, the Suzuki Racing Blue and the Black. I'm happy with the purchase. I'm super happy with the purchase. I really like riding this bike. Somehow I feel the amount of power what it has got, that is around 13 horsepower and 81 newton meters of torque, will keep me engaged for at least 3-4 years. So that's how I made the decision of purchasing Suzuki GSXS 150, guys. I hope some of the points what I have told in this video might help you in your purchase also. If it does, I'm really happy. That's it, guys, from my side. See you, take care. Till the next video, ride safe, ride hard.